Hello everybody, Echoes Nick 1 here, and today I'm going to be talking about the Space Patrol Luluco English dub. Space Patrol Luluco is a series of shorts produced by Trigger Studios, the same people who made such great anime as Kill la Kill and Lilwish Academia, and it was also directed by Hiroyuki Imashi, the same director for Kill la Kill and the animation director for Fooly Cooly, a Gainax production. It's a hilarious, ultra-fast-paced comedy set in, well, space for the most part. Plus, it has some pretty good messages for a series of shorts. The show focuses on Luluco, a middle schooler who lives in a space immigration zone in Japan named Ogikubo. Despite the fact that she lives amongst aliens, she tries to live a quote-unquote normal life. The premise of the show is that her father, Keiji, who works for Space Patrol, accidentally swallows a freezing pill and Luluco is forced to take his place as a member of Space Patrol to pay for her dad's unfreezing. Along the way, she's joined by Alpha Omega Nova, who serves as Luluco's love interest and plays a pivotal part in the story later on, and Midori, one of Luluco's classmates who's kinda shady and mostly a bitch, but in a good lovable type of way. They both join her in her Space Patrol adventures, and Overjustice, her chief, helps along the way. If you haven't watched the series, you should definitely watch it. However, I'm not here to review the series as a whole. Instead, as the title says, I'm specifically reviewing the very recent dub of the series by Funimation. There will be spoilers in small parts, but I will make sure to place a spoiler warning in the top right screen and give you 10 seconds to react. Also, please note that this is just my opinion and you are of course entitled to your own. Ready? Let's go. Luluco is framed as a naive high schooler who tries very hard to be normal, but she's also very responsible and mature. Take a listen to the sub and dub voices back to back.
Watashi Luluco. When I'm a normal middle school student.
普通じゃない街. 宇宙人と地球人が共に暮らす 銀河指定宇宙移民特区
Ogikubo. Earth. It's a cosmopolitan town where humans and aliens live side by side.
でも私本当はこの変な街が大嫌い.
I just want to be a normal girl in a normal town with a normal life.
I feel the original Japanese voice brings out the naive high schooler side of Luluco, the one who believes in a first love in high school due to the high pitch. She also sounds like a typical Japanese schoolgirl in anime, which seems fitting. When I first heard her voice in the trailer for the dub, it was a bit jarring. Her voice was deeper and she sounded more like an adult. However, I realized that this is what Western schoolgirls truly sound like, honestly. And as I watched the whole dub, I quickly got used to her voice. And I began to notice it perhaps brings out the more responsible and mature side of Luluco, who takes care of her father by making breakfast, is proactive, and is adaptable to her situation of becoming a member of Space Patrol. However, even though I felt the dub voice gave a very good yet different approach to the character, I noticed a few things that were off, even in the first episode. The translator seemed to have changed some of Luluco's lines. The iconic from the Japanese version is instead replaced with
"This guy's a whack job."
Later on episode 5, my personal favorite episode, though due to the introduction of Luluco Godspeed and the reveal of Overjustice's gun morphing, there's another noticeable change in her dialogue. Instead of the more humorous instead, we get
"I didn't even know he could stand up! Go Chief! You can do it!"
The line change seemed a bit weird to me, and I wasn't sure why they did it. However, to me now, it seems like the translators wanted to characterize Luluco a bit differently. Notice how her dialogue in the dub changes to a more personal remark towards Overjustice himself, whilst the original Japanese audio is Luluco remarking on the situation at hand. The dubbed Luluco seems to be more judgmental and people-oriented, albeit only a little perhaps, than the sub Luluco. Many would also notice that, similarly, in the sub and dub version of My Hero Academia, they changed Midoriya's characterization a bit. Speaking of Midoriya, this section won't be as in-depth, if you can call it that, as Luluco's one, because honestly, there's not much difference in his dialogue. Of course, there's different phrasings and such, but they mean essentially the same thing, and the dub really doesn't change anything about his character. Probably because he doesn't have any real character. For those of you who haven't watched the show yet, that's not a critique, it's actually the point of his character, really. He's supposed to be seen as this boy who is quite two-dimensional, and a point is made to show Luluco's infatuation with him. It's merely that, infatuation, a naive middle school crush. This unsympathetic, nonchalant feel to the character is, I think, perfectly encapsulated by dub voice actor Justin Briner.
I don't mind one way or another. This is such a strange town. Even seeing it, it's hard to believe that humans and aliens live here together.
Oh, really? I've lived here all my life, so I guess it just seems normal to me.
It's not. Let's do our best.
Also, does that voice sound familiar to you? Perhaps because Justin Briner also did the voice acting for the English dub of My Hero Academia, voicing the protagonist, Izuku Midoriya. So that's a fun fact. In fact, a lot of the voice actors in this dub are dubbers from very well-known anime, and even things outside of anime. We'll see this in the next character too. Midoriya is depicted as a conniving loose cannon. The perfect way to describe her would be chaotic neutral. She plays the role of villain in episode 3, but somehow makes her way into serving the side of justice on Space Patrol in episode 4, with no transition whatsoever. The dub amplifies Midoriya's sarcasm and cynicism with a dub voice that perfectly brings out the aforementioned personality traits.
Yeah? What you want, Luluco?
Do you know anything about this quasi-legal black hole app somebody's been selling?
Sure. Why are you looking to download app?
She's voiced by Jamie Marchi, who also voiced Quetzalcoatl in Miss Kobayashi's Dragon Maid. Midoriya in the dub is given a stereotypical valley girl accent, which makes her snark way better.
A little late for that, old man.
However, I have to say I do prefer the voice in the original Japanese version, but it just comes down to personal preference. Coming from having watched the sub originally, the dub voice was really jarring considering the voice of Midoriya in the sub, Mayumi Shintani, voice Haruko in Fooly Cooly and Best Girl in Kill la Kill, brought a completely different voice, and the two voices give very different experiences and interpretations.
Ouch. Relax. Knowing those clowns, it'll be a while before they manage to find us.
It's really up to personal preference, I think. As a proud fan of Inferno Cop and Flaming Skeletons and Skeletons in general, Overjustice is easily my favorite character out of the whole cast. He can play the stoic badass, but is never afraid to show a more goofy, childlike demeanor. His overattachment to the idea of justice is hilarious, and he is often extremely oblivious to most things, which leads to extremely funny situations and interactions. The dub mostly captures this image of Overjustice well. However, one of the funniest things about Japanese Overjustice is his constant use of English. That's bad English for the uninitiated.
Overjustice! Justice! Justice. Yatta! Justice is a miracle! Justice! I'm not justice, watashi no justice! Love is justice!
Making the very way he said the word justice sound funny. Unfortunately, since the voice actor for the dub speaks, surprises of surprises, English, the same pattern of speech is not preserved.
Over justice! The Space Patrol suit, Luluco! And go forth to mete out justice! Justice! It is a manifestation of your own justice. Hello there, new justice recruit. Thank you for coming all the way out here.
Bob Carter does do a good job as an alternative to Tetsu Inada's masterful voice acting, but you can never beat the original. I have two fun facts about both voice actors here. Bob Carter also voices Balrog in Street Fighter, and I can't stop imagining Overjustice when I play him now. Tetsu Inada also voiced Iragamagori in Kill la Kill and Deca Master Doggy Kruger in the Super Sentai series Deca Ranger, which was adapted into Power Rangers SPD for American audiences. Interestingly, Space Patrol Luluco was inspired by both versions of the series. Some of Doggy Kruger's characteristics were added to Overjustice, and the SPD Morpher slash Deca Brace is seen in Episode 3. SPD and Power Rangers also stood for Space Patrol Delta, and you can see the parallels in the name. Wow, I went off on a tangent there. Anyways, back to the review. In my opinion, Keiji's voice matches his appearance perfectly in the dub. Honestly, this section will be short because I think his voice in the dub actually surpasses the one in the sub. The gruff, deep voice looks exactly what I'd imagine Keiji to sound like. His voice is slightly higher pitched than the original Japanese version, which means for some better comedy moments, but in general, I think the dub voice is more fitting.
Hey Dad, morning!
Good morning, Luluco!
Something interesting to note is that Overjustice and KG say their own gun morphing calls whilst the kids just have the automated voice. It's probably just because they're using cadet uniforms, but hey, it's something interesting. Also, I like KG's gun morphing and call in the sub better. Listen to how goofy it is. Luluco Godspeed is my second favorite character of the entire cast, mainly because she's just a walking trigger reference. She's the epitome of this series. She wields a corrupted version of Shiny Rod, which she even transforms into Shiny Arc like it's no big deal. Her cape is made of life fibers, and her gun morphing is just the life fibers turning into a gun, and her body isn't actually affected, which I find pretty funny. She's a supportive mom, and she knows what she's talking about, but I wouldn't say she's a good mom, even the slightest. I think her voice also really suits her well. In fact, I think the voices in the sub and dub are the most similar for Luluco.
The air on this planet is as putridly polluted as ever. And the gravity is killing me. I'm gonna need a massage when I get off of this rock.
To round this off, let's go through a few of the side characters. Sex and Violence with Mock Speed was a short that I wasn't too interested in, so no real comments here. Inferno Cop definitely sounds 21.
A middle schooler in love for the first time is invincible. What matters is telling the person you love how you feel. Everything that comes after that is just a bonus.
Thank you, sir. You've been a big help.
Don't call me sir. I'm only 21. I'm dead, not old.
I don't imagine him with that voice, but I guess it matches with the Japanese dub quite well. Susie is great as always. The voice to me kinda sounds off, but I think it's just a fast pace.
Weird, what just happened?
Is that spell how you turned into a gun?
Who are you?
It's none of your business, but my name is Susie Mon Barbaran. I'm a student here at the Magic Academy.
Obviously, the voice actress is the same in both the Little Witch Academia and Luluco dubs. And the secretary's voice has wild differences to her voice in the original Japanese dub, but I think the two interpretations are just as good as each other. In conclusion, I think the dub is great and provides some fun new interpretations to the characters. It's at least interesting to see how translators and dubbers handle them. The voices take a while to get used to if you've watched the sub beforehand, but they grow on you. Overall, I'd give this dub a solid 8 out of 10. It's not perfect and some of the humor is lost as there is no more English to be found, but it's pretty good nonetheless. So I hope you took something away from this video, and I hope you have fun watching this anime. Leave your thoughts down below. Do you like the sub better or the dub better? I'm XSIC1, signing out.